Hi everyone, I'm a tutor. My videos are mostly for beginner PC users. First of all, I want to explain a bit what is a clean install of Windows is, what are its pros and cons. When a user buy a new computer, that computer run as fast as possible. Fast as hardware, it's made of allows. Usually the computer is used every day. From time to time, various errors, crashes, freezes, and other glitches occur. Over time, all this accumulates in the system. This slows down the computer. How to return the computer to its previous speed? A clean install of Windows is one way. It's free and relatively easy. What is a clean install of Windows? A clean installation is a process of erasing the hardware and setting up a new fresh copy of Windows 10. Everything that was in the old system will be deleted, including the system itself. As a result of clean installation, a fresh copy of Windows will be installed on the computer. In this case, the computer will be as just from the store. You will not find your settings, programs, passwords, bookmarks in Windows. All your files will be deleted from the desktop, library folders and other folders of the computer on the system drive. This is considered to be a disadvantage of clean install. All errors, crashes and glitches will also be removed. The computer will run almost as fast as after you brought it from the store. This is considered to be a main advantage of clean installation. How to quickly deal with the cons that I mentioned? Before clean install, you need to prepare for it. Now I will only talk about files. Perhaps your disk has a separate partition for storing files. I'll open Disk Management, right click on the Start button. I choose Disk Management. This is the main disk of the computer. It looks like there is no separate disk partition for files. It is System Reserved Bootloader section. This is a drive where Windows is installed. This is a Service Recovery partition. If you have enough disk space, you can create a separate partition for files. You can do it like this. Right click on the disk partition where Windows is installed. In context menu, there is an item Shrink Volume. If this item is active, click on it. In this window, you can enter the size by which to shrink the disk. I will shrink the 15,000 megabytes partition. I enter in this field. Press Shrink. Volume shrunk, there is unallocated space. Now I need to create a partition on it. Right click, choose New Simple Volume, press Next, Next again, once again Next. Here I recommend assigning a label to the partition. This will help prevent accidental deletion of the partition during installation. I remove the default label. I will enter my files here. You come up with a label that you understand. Press Next and Finish. Now I can copy the necessary files to this partition. For example, from the desktop and other computer folders. I will keep this partition during a clean install. This is just one step to preparing for the clean install. I'm planning some videos about it. An even more reliable solution is to copy the necessary files to external drives, flash drives, etc. Let's move to practice. This computer is currently running Windows 10. Let's assume it has been running for a long time. Over time it began to work more slowly. Errors often occur. I decided to do a clean install. For a clean install today, a bootable USB flash drive is used. I'm using a flash drive that I created in these videos. The link to the playlist can be found in the description of this video. I connect my flash drive to my computer. Now I need to boot from it. To do this, I can enter the BIOS and set up booting from the USB flash drive. A faster way is boot menu. To call the boot menu, you need to press a certain key on the keyboard when booting or rebooting. The key depends on the PC manufacturer. On this computer, the boot menu is invoked by pressing F9. I turn on reboot. I press F9. Boot menu appeared. The type of boot menu depends on the PC manufacturer. Your menu may look different, the work algorithm is similar. This is a list of the boot devices for this computer. To boot from a flash drive, I need to find it in the list and select it. My flash drive is easy to find. It was made by the famous manufacturer SanDisk. Here is my flash drive. I just need to select the flash drive down arrow key and press enter. Here you need to quickly press any key. The computer boots from the flash drive. In this first window, usually no one select anything. Next. Here I click install now. In this list, you can select the edition of Windows. For example, Pro. If you don't see this window, watch this video. I show it a simple solution to the problem when the Windows editorial selection list does not appear. I choose Pro. Next. Here I accept the terms of license. Next. Here I can choose the installation type. This choice is a system upgrade. It will not allow you to achieve maximum speed of the OS. The second option is install only. This is a clean install of the OS. I choose it. In this window I need to delete unnecessary partition and leave the necessary ones. When user does a clean install of Windows, he needs to remove all partition except for the partition on which he saved the necessary files. The section that I created is easy to find by label. I leave this section. I select the bootloader partition. Delete. Confirm. I select the section with Windows. Before clicking delete, I want to warn you again. All files, programs, settings, passwords, bookmarks from the section will be deleted. Now I delete. I leave the section with my label. If I delete recovery partition, then the installer will create it here. If I leave the recovery partition, then it will be used in the new system. I won't touch this section. To continue the installation, I allocate unallocated space. Click Next. Installation has begun. We are waiting for the first reboot. At the first reboot, it's better to disconnect the USB flash drive. It is no longer needed. second stage of installation. If your country is not defined correctly, you can select it from the list. I click Yes. Selecting a keyboard layout, I'll leave United Kingdom as the default. Yes. If you need to add layout, you can do it after installation. Skip. I set up my computer for personal use. Choose this. Next. If you want to sign in your Microsoft account right now, you can type your login and after press next your password. If you're using a local Windows account, click offline account. Microsoft wants to connect me. He wrote that these services will not be available to me. For use local account, I click limited experience. Here you need to come up with the name for your account and enter it in this field. I will enter this name. Next. The password can be configured after the system is installed and configured. Next. In this setup, privacy settings may be configured. Users who believe that Windows is watching them disable all toggles switches. Others leave everything as default. I'll turn it off as an example. Accept. Here I click skip. A few minutes of waiting more. That's it. I did to clean install Windows 10. After installation, check and enable updates. After that, wait until the updates Windows components are downloaded. If your computer is not new, then most drivers will be downloaded and installed automatically. The rest can be downloaded and installed from the website of your device manufacturer. Let's talk in other videos about installing drivers in more details. If earlier on this computer you already had Windows 10 activated, then you don't have to worry about activation. After the installation is complete, Windows 10 will automatically be activated online. To check activation status in Windows 10, select the Start button and then select Settings, Update and Security, Activation. Check activation status here. We will talk about other issues related to activation in other videos. Restart your computer after installing the updates. After this, your computer is ready to install the necessary programs and make the settings you are used to. Thanks for watching my videos. If the video are helpful, please like, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next video. Perhaps the video will be useful to your friends. Please share with them. I wish health to all viewers. My name is Evgeny Yurtaev. See you soon.